Canadian real estate could be on its way back to all-time high pricing by end of 2024, according to Bloomberg. And I'm not saying this is going to happen, but I do think it is a possibility. I'm that agent Kelly. I talk about Canadian real estate in my local market of Vancouver, Abbotsford, Fraser Valley, all things BC. If you're into that kind of thing, subscribe to the channel, like this video to help me out. And if you want to chat one-on-one, you can do so by clicking on the link in my description and booking yourself into my calendar. So let's check this out. Home prices across Canada are expected to climb next year, with expected Bank of Canada rate cuts poised to reinvigorate the housing market, according to a new report. Royal LePage's 2024 market survey, released Thursday, predicts that home prices will make incremental gains in the first half of the year. Those gains will be followed by larger price increases in the second half of the year, spurred by expected interest rate cuts from the Bank of Canada after a historic rate hiking cycle. Now, all the comments are going to say, well, this is Royal LePage. Of course they want home prices to go up, blah, 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 blah. Fair enough. Whatever. So where are home prices headed? Royal LePage is forecasting aggregate home prices in Canada to rise 3.3% in the first quarter of 2024 on an annual basis, followed by 0.2% year-over-year increase in the second quarter. And in the third quarter, Royal LePage anticipates home price will rise 3.3% compared to the previous year, followed by a 5.5% year-over-year bump in the fourth quarter. So next year, at the end of next year, in comparison to prices today, they'll be 5.5% higher, landing at a median home price of $843,000, back to the highest reached during the COVID-19 pandemic. Based on this forecast, by the end of next year, home prices will have essentially climbed back to their pandemic peak reached in the first quarter of 2022. Now, obviously, this is Canadian home prices, but if Canadian home prices are to rise, so will the prices in Vancouver. So this article will, by today's standard, be viewed as FUD, which is interesting. I remember when you would talk about prices going up, and that wouldn't be FUD. In fact, just the opposite would be fear, uncertainty, and doubt. When you talk about prices going down, that is FUD. But today, when you talk about prices going up, you're apparently FUDing the market. This is what I think. I think real estate will be back at all-time highs within the next 3 years. Will it happen next year? I personally don't think so. However, I think it's a very real possibility. I had somebody come up to me at the gym the other day that follows my social media, and we were having a conversation, and he said to me, I just hate how the Vancouver real estate market is driven by FOMO. So much of the market is driven by FOMO. And I thought about it, and I was like, he is absolutely right. And although he's right, and I don't think it's healthy for a market to operate like that, I also don't think you're wrong for feeling that way. I think at this point, you have to respect Vancouver real estate's ability to rip to the upside violently at any given moment. Perfect example, real life example for you guys. In 2014, I could have bought a townhome in Clayton Heights. They were roughly 300 grand at that time, low 300,000, 320, 330. And I let a family member talk me out of it because they were like, oh, you know, prices are gonna go down, just rent, save up a bigger down payment, all the normal, you know, rhetoric. And I didn't buy it. And 2 years later in 2016, we all know what happened in 2016, that same townhome was worth like $550,000, like almost $600,000. And that is the exact reason why I live in Abbotsford today. I got priced out of my own market that I live in. Last year, end of 2022, everybody was calling for this large recession, spring 2023, market crash, skies falling, et cetera, et cetera. And townhomes in Langley and Maple Ridge literally went up 100 grand in like a month. Prices overall across pretty much everywhere went up 10 to 12% in just 3 to 4 months in like one of the worst real estate markets ever. So like when it comes to the FOMO thing, I get that it's not healthy and nobody likes that is how the market operates. There's also a lot of people out there that will say like, don't get wrapped up in the FOMO. Don't just jump into the market, you know, relax, do it when you're ready type of thing. And I don't agree with that either. I think the answer is somewhere in the middle of that. And because I listened to that advice, it cost me a lot of money. And that's why I lived 30 minutes away from where I actually wanted to live. Now I like it in Abbotsford, but I guess what I'm trying to say is, you have to respect Vancouver real estate's ability to just go up out of nowhere. So do I think that we're gonna hit all-time highs by the end of 2024? I don't, but I definitely wouldn't be surprised if we did. Am I telling you to buy right now? Absolutely not. do whatever the hell you want to do. But what I'm saying is that it's probably not a bad idea, given everything that's going on. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm That Agent Kelly. I'm making moves to move you. Peace.